everybody, my name is Amanda, and today I'm going to show you how to screen print. Screen print is also known as silk screening, and it's a method of printing when you send ink through a really fine mesh or screen to get a really detailed image. So the first thing you want to do is get on an apron, and then you want to grab your emulsion out of the refrigerator, and we keep emulsion in the refrigerator so it lasts longer and has longer shelf life, but you'll want to let it thaw out for about 15 minutes. And then while you're letting it thaw out, you want to grab your screen. So this is what a screen looks like. It's basically polyester that's stretched over a metal frame. It doesn't look like that there would be holes in these, but they're really, really fine, which is important for printing because then that's how you get detail. First process of prepping your screen is to clean it with simple green. This process is called degreasing. And degreasing your screen will get any imperfections that are caught in your screens. It's most likely that your screen was sitting out for a while, so it has probably caught some dust in the mesh, or maybe whoever used it last maybe left a little bit of ink, or there's fingerprints or oil. Really could be anything, so degreasing is an important step to clearing out any of those imperfections before you put emulsion onto it. So you bring your screen into your sink, and you're going to spray it with water. And then you're gonna spray it with your simple green and scrub it. So first, you wanna spray your screen. You wanna make sure you get both sides. Just give it a nice quick rinse, and then you're gonna spray it with your simple green on both sides. And then you take your scrubby pad and you're gonna scrub it vertically and horizontally. And then I usually do a little bit of circular motions just to really make sure that the screen is going to get clean. Once you've scrubbed it down, then you're going to spray it with water, and it's really important to make sure all the bubbles get off, because if any simple green is left on the screen before you put emulsion on it, then it's possible that your emulsion will fall off in the next processes. Even when I see when the bubbles are all gone, I still spray it for some extra time to really make sure that that simple green gets pushed to the screen and it's no longer there. So now that we have a clean screen, we can set it in front of a fan to dry for about 10 minutes. If you're working in a studio, it's most likely you're going to be working with other people, and sometimes people might be drying their screens at the same time. So it is really important to make sure you stack your screens properly while they're waiting to dry. So if there is another screen laying out to dry, you never want to lay it this way, because it's really possible that the edges from the metal frame could fall onto the screen and it could puncture it, which would rupture the whole screen, and then it would be broken and you'd have to get it sent somewhere to be restretched. So if you have double screens waiting to be dried, always stack them with the metal frames up against one another. Okay, once your screen is dry, you can set it up onto a counter and you'll want to have your emulsion out, which has already been sitting out for 15 minutes. If it was in a refrigerator, you'll want to get a spoon, because that's where you're going to scoop the emulsion, a scraper to get the emulsion off back into the bucket after you're done, and a trough. Now, you'll never want to take the lid off of your emulsion where it's light, because it is light sensitive, which means if it sees light, it'll start to harden, and you don't want that, and that's really bad for the emulsion. But if you're in a studio, you can have this type of yellow fluorescent light, which gives you some vision, but it won't mess up with your emulsion. Now, this whole next process, I'm going to show you how the action of it works with the lights on, so you can see what I'm doing. So in the dark, you'll want to have taken off your lid and take your spoon and fill up your trough. I usually fill up my trough with emulsion to about right here, which is a lot. You're not going to end up using that much at all, but part of the process is to tilt your trough at about a 45 degree angle like this, and you want to keep it sitting there, pressed up against the screen until all of the emulsion kind of creeps up to the screen. And you want to start at the bottom. An important part of this process is to make sure your completely flat side is facing you. You don't want to put emulsion where the screen indents, because then it's going to take a really long time to dry. So once you have emulsion in your trough, and kind of hold it for probably about 30 seconds at this angle so it kind of creeps up to that edge, then you're going to press it against here and wait for it to a little bit of it to get onto the screen. And then you're going to do one big fast motion upwards. And once you hit the top, you can do a little bit of a squeal to kind of get any of that excess emulsion back into your trough so none of it drips down. So I'll show you how to do that a few times. And you want to apply it a decent amount of pressure because you really want that emulsion to get on there. You don't want it on light. And you don't want it on thick, but you don't also want it on too light. I've definitely screwed this up a few times, and the more you do it, you kind of get the kind of pressure that you need and how much is on there. And if you do feel like you put too much emulsion on the screen, take that angle back and just kind of scrape it up so you can kind of get some of that excess off. So I'll show you again. The same amount of pressure that you would want to apply to this is probably about 10 pounds, I would say. Probably the same amount you would to push a really heavy door. Once that is done, the light's still off, you're going to want to put your emulsion back into your bucket and scrape it off, because it is most likely that you're going to have extra, and you don't want to be wasting that. And then once you have it all scraped out into the bucket, put the lid back on, and then you can turn on the lights, and then bring these three items to a sink where the drain won't get clogged and rinse them off thoroughly. So once you have your screen coated, make sure you store your screen into an area where there won't be any lights before you turn the lights back on. Where we store ours is just right underneath the table, and we just have a black tarp over a shelf.
While you're waiting for your emulsion to dry is a really good time to get your drawings ready. So you can put drawings on either a printed material. Some studios have a special printer where it prints off your films for screen printing, or you can hand draw them, which is what I did. This was drawn on acetate, which is a little bit of a glossier substance, but this was drawn with a micron pen, which blocks out light, which is really important. And this was drawn on Mylar with India ink, which also blocks out light. Because where your drawing is when it's placed on the exposing bed, then that light isn't going to shine through, and that's what's gonna get washed out. Once your emulsion is dry and ready to go, you can grab your screen, but make sure the lights are off, and then you can bring it to the exposing bed, which is this guy right here. And what will happen is we'll shut this over the screen, and it'll be completely dark, but then underneath there's lights which will expose the parts of the screen where you don't want ink to go through, and it will harden that emulsion. So emulsion is like a glue, and then once it sees light, it hardens. So then it blocks those little holes in the screen, and then you'll be able to put ink through it.
You can lay your images flat on the exposing bed and make sure if you have any writing on it, you don't have to flip it the opposite way. So you can lay it down on normal way that you read. Then place your screen on top. Close the bed and seal it. And then you can turn it on. There's little vacuums in the inside, and it's going to suck this black material down, which is important because then it's going to hold your image really close to the screen so then it doesn't expose where you don't want it to. And then you'll get really fine detail. And once it's completely flat, then you can turn on your exposing bed, then let the UV light on for a minute and 30 seconds. Once your image is done being exposed, then you can take it out of the exposing bed and bring it back to your sink. And now we're going to wash it out with the power hose, and then the part where the emulsion did not see light, then that's going to start to wash out because it did not harden. So I'll show you how that works. For this next part, we're going to be using a power hose, so it's really important to wear hearing protection. and then you can turn your power hose on and you can spray the part of the screen where you had placed your image, and then that emulsion will start to wash out.
Where the screen is starting to turn yellow is where ink is now going to be able to push through because there's no emulsion in these yellow sections of the screen. You want to spray it until you can see that all that green emulsion is gone and pushed through the screen, but you also don't want to spray too much because then you start to get chips out of the screen. Like right here, I didn't necessarily want that gone, but there is a way to fix that.
This process of screen printing, you need to be careful to not spray too much and not to spray too little. And so now once your screen is done, then you can bring it in front of the fan until it's dry, and then we start our next process. Once your screen is done drying, then you can put it onto these hinges, which is a special kind of screen print table. And they just have little hinges and butterfly wings that hold the screen in place, and then you're able to lift it up and down. Like I had said before, if there's parts of your screen that got chipped away, and the emulsion disappeared where you didn't want it to, then you can fill that screen with screen filler. This will fill in the screen so then ink won't go through. When you use screen filler, you want to make sure you put something underneath the screen and the table, so then that way you're not going to end up painting screen filler right onto the table if you want some, a little bit of breathing room. So you just take a paintbrush and fill in those areas where you don't want the ink to go through. While you're waiting for your screen filler to harden, you can lay down your tape. You want to lay down tape around the edges of the screen where it's still yellow, where your emulsion didn't cover, because if you were to push ink through the screen, wherever it's yellow, ink is going to get onto your paper or your fabric or whatever you're printing on. So around these edges here is where you're going to lay down tape. And if there's sections where you didn't use screen filler and it's just easier to cover with tape, like this section here, I'm not going to be even printing right there, so I'm just going to cover that with tape. So once you have your screen filler dry and your tape on the screen and you have it hinged onto your board, then you're ready to print. The next materials you need for printing is a little scoop, and you only need one that's a little bit bigger than your image size, your ink, and a little scoop. And you want to place your ink just right above where your image is, and then you're going to do what's called flooding the screen, where you take your scooper, you lift up the screen and push that ink through. This just pushes it through that mesh a little bit, so then you're ready for prints. So I'm going to take your paper, place it right underneath where you're going to be printing from, lay down the screen flat, take your scoop, and you might want to put a little bit more ink. Hold the scoop at a 45 degree angle and apply decent pressure, probably about 10 to 15 pounds, and bring the scoop towards your navel. And then you kind of do that just to kind of get your ink off. And then hold your paper down before you lift the screen. And there you have a print. I'm going to show you all this again at a closer angle. So place your paper underneath where your image is going to be. Set your screen down. And then I'm at a weird angle and I can't, it's really hard to pull upwards. I'm just going to take my scoop and bring that ink back to the top. Hold your scoop at a 45 degree angle, apply about 10 to 15 pounds, and bring it towards your navel really fast. Get off that excess ink off. Place your scoop down, make sure you don't have any ink on your hands before you touch your paper, and then bring up your screen. And it looks like I missed a little bit of screen filler right here, so I would go back and fix that later, but there you go, there you have it. And that's how you screen print. Well, thank you for watching. I hope all of you learned a little bit of something about screen printing. It's a really good way to get one piece of art just reproduced over and over again. It's really fast, it's easy, and it's really fun. And I hope you learned a lot about screen printing. Bye.